I bring word, sire. There are demands from the Bannorn that you step down from the Regency. They are said to be gathering their forces, as are your allies. It appears it will be civil war after all, despite the Darkspawn. Pity. I also have an interesting report. There seem to be Grey Wardens who survived Ostagar. How, I don't know. But they will act against you. I have arranged for a solution, with your leave.
The Antivan Crows send their regards.
An assassin?
Against Grey Wardens, we will need the very best.
And the most expensive.
Just get it done.
Understand. You look like a woman. You are a Grey Warden, so it follows that you can't be a woman. Women are priests, artisans, shopkeepers, or farmers. They don't fight. Why would women ever wish to be men? That makes no sense. Do they also wish to live on the moon? That's as attainable. One of those things can't be true. A person is born, Gunari or human or elven or dwarf. He doesn't choose that. The size of his hands, whether he is clever or foolish, the land he comes from, the color of his hair, these are beyond his control. We do not choose, we simply are. Can they? We'll see.
What do you need? Ask away. Did I say that? I meant that dogs raised me. Giant slobbering dogs from the Anderfells. A whole pack of them, in fact. Well, if you're going to go and pay attention to the facts, then fine. Let's see, how do I explain this? I'm a bastard, and before you make any smart comments, I mean the fatherless kind. My mother was a serving girl in Redcliff Castle who died when I was very young. Arl Eamon wasn't my father, but he took me in anyhow to put a roof over my head. He was good to me, and he didn't have to be. I respect the man, and I don't blame him anymore for sending me off to the Chantry once I was old enough. I know who I was told was my father. He died even before my mother did, anyhow. It isn't important. Arl Eamon eventually married a young woman from Orlais, which caused all sorts of problems between him and the king because it was so soon after the war. But he loved her. Anyhow, then you, Arlesa, resented the rumors which pegged me as his bastard. They weren't true, but of course they existed. The Arl didn't care, but she did. So off I was packed to the nearest monastery at age 10, just as well. The Arlesa made sure the castle wasn't a home to me by that point. She despised me. Maybe. She felt threatened by my presence, I can see that now. I can't say I blame her. She wondered if the rumors were true herself, I bet. I remember I had an amulet with Andraste's holy symbol on it. The only thing I had of my mother's. I was so furious at being sent away, I tore it off and threw it at the wall and it shattered. Stupid thing to do. The Arl came by the monastery a few times to see how I was, but I was stubborn. I hated it there. And blamed him for everything. And eventually, he just stopped coming. And raised by dogs. Or I may as well have been, the way I acted. But maybe all young bastards act like that. I don't know. All I know is that the Arl is a good man and well-loved by the people. He also was King Kaelin's uncle. So he has a personal motivation to see Loghain pay for what he did. Anyway, that's really all there is to the story.
What do you wish of me? If you must. My mother has been hunted from time to time, yes, by Templar fools like Alistair, which should tell you how successful they generally were. Flemeth made a bit of a game of it, in fact. The Templars would come again, and she would look at me and smile and say that the fun was to begin once more. I am unsure. I was too young to understand, and perhaps it was bravado on Flemeth's part. Or perhaps she was merely amused. I will never know. Flemeth would warn them once. It was a warning they inevitably failed to heed. And then the true game began. Often Flemeth would use me as bait, a little girl to scream and run and lure the Templars deeper into the wilds and to their doom. Sometimes, eventually. Thankfully, the wilds is a vast place. Once they found us, Flemeth would simply move us elsewhere and we would be lost within the forest once again. I did not understand the danger we faced until I was much older. I had never heard of apostates or maleficarum. I think that my mother made it fun so that a child did not learn to fear. And I think that it was necessary. There are no trials for apostates, no prisons, no mercy. There are only absolutes, so only survival matters. If the wilds have taught me anything, 'tis this. First, you must survive. Do you disagree? An interesting answer for a mage. Enough of this talk. Let us return to the task at hand.
Yes? Something you need? Yes? What's on your mind? What is meant by someone like me? And there were no beautiful, charming women in the cloisters, you think? You would be wrong. There were many lovely young initiates in the Lothering Cloister, all of them chaste and virtuous. It added to their mystique. Because then, they were forbidden, and forbidden fruit is the sweeter, no? My fruit? I can't believe I'm having this conversation. But no, I did not take vows. The Chantry provides succor and safe harbor to all who seek it. I chose to stay and become affirmed. I was a traveling minstrel in Orlais. Tales and songs were my life. I performed, and they rewarded me with applause and coin. And my skill in battle? Well, you pick up different skills when you travel, yes? Yes, of course. Let's move on.